Hey everybody, it's Duke Coupon Corey here, and this video is a little bit different, a little bit longer than some of my usual ones. Been doing the Uber Eats DoorDash thing on the side, and decided to share with everyone out there what goes on when your delivery driver's out there picking up food for you, and to give you some tips, some things to keep in mind when you are waiting on your food or placing an order, etc. And sat down with friend of mine and fellow YouTuber Jason Moneyman Brown, and I'll put in the description area a link to Jason's page. He kind of gives financial advice, kind of ties in with the coupon thing. So this is kind of a cross promotional video we did together. So check out my video, please like and subscribe. Check out Jason's stuff and subscribe to him too. Show you the video now.
All right, Jason Brown here. Now today I'm joined by my good friend Mr. Duke Corey, and we're going to be kind of going behind the scenes of some of these the delivery service apps, right? So a lot of people during the pandemic have really used these food delivery service apps to their advantage, with several of them being Postmates, Uber Eats, DoorDash. These are probably three of the most popular ones. And today we're just gonna kind of go behind the scenes of the inner workings of how these apps work with someone, my friend Duke here, who's experienced both sides of the equation with them. He's ordered food from them, and he's also worked for them as a delivery service man. So Duke, thanks so much for sharing your insight today. And we will just kind of jump right into it. I've used some of these apps kind of sparingly. I'm not a big food delivery guy, but I have used some, especially during the pandemic. And, you know, to me, it's always been kind of curious, like, you know, how do these work? Because every time I order a food item from a local restaurant here, we're in the Atlanta area. For those of you who are wondering, we're in the Atlanta market. The experiences are always a little bit different, right? Sometimes you'll get the food right away. Sometimes you're waiting an hour and a half. Sometimes I've ordered food and I've waited over an hour, and they send you the text updates and it'll say, your food is on the way in 10 minutes. Your food is on the way in 5 minutes. Your driver is, and then when it's time for the food be delivered, it'll say, your food order has been canceled. And I'm like, what happened? So just share some of your stories. Like, how did you, kind of get into this, and let us know kind of what happens behind the scenes, I guess, sure. And how these orders are fulfilled.
Well, about a year ago, things started shutting down, as you know. And so to kind of help make ends meet, because some of my other work was kind of on a freelance independent contractor basis, and a lot of the events I was would normally work were being canceled. So I'm not one to sit around and just hope money falls from the sky. I actually a recommendation from my brother, because he said, well, think about what people need right now. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people are stuck at home. We had shutdowns, we're told to stay home.
You know, quarantines.
People were quarantining. People were working from home.
Schools and, were closed.
Right. Kids were home, and people don't want to cook for every single meal. So he said, you should look into this food delivery. I think that's going to be something that's still going to be happening, even if everything else is shutting down. Mm-hmm. And I thought to myself, you know, he's got a very good point. That may be something I wouldn't mind doing. So I looked into it, and it was slow at first, but, you know, mainly because I was kind of getting used to it. And originally I was with Postmates, which in some areas is more popular than others. We're kind of, like you said, the metro Atlanta area. Some pockets it works really well in, some pockets it doesn't. But then after that, I got on with DoorDash. And after, I think at the time, so many people were doing it, there was actually a waiting list
okay.
to get on it.
Okay.
So I didn't get on Uber maybe a month later after applying online. But anyway, but once I got going, it kind of snowballed, and some of my work has returned, but I'm still doing it on the side when work slows down, or if I have a free weekend, because, you know, if you got nothing to do, you might as well make some money. So it's easy, it's convenient. So I like doing it, but I have noticed things happen throughout the course of making these deliveries, and I always say to myself, I bet the customer isn't aware of what's happening. And that's what gave me this idea to talk to you and talk to them. And
right.
And for you know that I've been doing this, so you've like texted me a few times going like, hey, why did this DoorDash order take so long? You do DoorDash. What's up with that?
That's right.
And then I started asking you some questions, and I thought, you know, well, maybe we should just talk about it on a camera and get it out there for the world.
Sure.
So I'm trying to think of just some quick examples.
Sometimes both DoorDash and Uber Eats will give you two to pick up at the same time.
Okay.
So say I go to a pizza place. Like, I'm picking up for Sam and Jenny. I'm just generic names off the top of my head.
Okay.
So the two separate orders going to two different locations, right? Two different customers. But they both came in around the same. And I assume the way they do it is, well, these two drop-offs are near each other, or one's on the way to the other.
Okay.
So they're trying to, you know, expedite it, which makes sense. And they and you make more because you're doing a double delivery. So they say, you know, you get paid more because you're doing more, which makes sense.
Okay.
It's one pickup, two drop-offs.
Right.
So when I arrive, they'll go, oh, I'm picking up for, I forgot the name.
Sam and Jenny.
here's one for Sam. Jenny's got another 10 minutes until it's ready.
Okay.
I can't leave because I got to wait for Jenny's. Sam doesn't know that.
Okay.
And I feel bad for Sam.
And Sam's food is getting cold.
Well, hopefully they have it on I have food warming bags.
Yeah, that's right.
Which, you know, are perfect, but they help. They definitely help.
That's right.
Actually, that's a good point. Sometimes I'll say, well, I'm going to go and stick this in the car, and then I'll come back for the other one.
Okay.
So I get it in the warmer as quickly as possible so it stays warm. Some restaurants are good about, like, pizza places will leave it on top of the oven.
Okay.
It's heated, you know. Like, mm-hmm. They'll do their best effort to keep it warm. But, I worry the food's going to get cold.
Yep.
And I worry that they're just going to get upset that it's taking a long time.
Okay.
So I always feel bad that, for example, Sam's food's ready. Mm-hmm. Sam has to wait on Jenny's.
Yeah.
No, like, Sam's being punished, you know, for no reason on the wait.
Right.
And they may not know that. And then I may get the food and Jenny's may be before Sam.
That's right.
Go to Jenny's first. I'm like, oh, well, Sam's got to wait even longer now.
Right.
So, and then, you know, another example, I can lump this into that scenario, but sometimes apartment complexes can be quite confusing.
Oh, okay.
And the GPS isn't always accurate.
Right.
It tells you to take a left to go to, you know, the H building, but I should have went to the right or something. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I've been in an apartment complex for 5 or 10 minutes, driver. I sometimes get the customer contacting me because they can call or text usually. Yeah. Say, you just passed me.
Oh, no.
So, like, sometimes they're watching us. And if I actually suggest that if you're a customer out there to watch the little icon. I think they show I've used Uber Eats a couple of times myself. You can see the driver. Okay. And that actually happened to me. I ordered from Taco Mac, and no, it was Zaxby's.
Okay.
And I think Taco Mac was right by Zaxby's. So they sent the customer to Taco Mac. That's another thing. Sometimes the double pickups can be at two different restaurants near each other.
Okay.
So you get one at Zaxby's, then you go to Taco Mac,
right.
Then you got to go to the two customers.
Okay.
And guess whose customer was last in that equation? Me. Okay. So I was Sam in that scenario.
Right.
I had to wait on my food. And it didn't take terribly long. It wasn't that bad.
Okay.
But I just thought, like, I don't think and this doesn't happen on every order, but on maybe a busy weekend or mm-hmm. something, or if there's not many drivers out there,
right. They
say, well, we need to maximize whatever drivers we have. That's another thing that may make it take a while.
Okay.
They may looking for a driver close by. I've gotten some random offers, like, you know, pick up here, and it's maybe like 15 minutes away. And I'm like, am I really the closest one? Okay, I'll do it. So depending where the driver is, when we accept the offer, we're given the offer, the delivery mm-hmm. offer, you first have to wait for us to drive to the place.
Okay.
We might be right around the corner. We might be 20 minutes away. So we got to get to the place, and then usually it's ready. It's not uncommon for it not to be ready.
Okay.
Even if it's a single order.
Right.
You know? I had one earlier today. Again, a pizza place. Pizza is very popular for deliveries.
Yeah.
They said, I think that just came in.
Okay.
Even though I accepted it like 5 or 10 minutes ago, the restaurant, it just came in. Or if a restaurant's really busy, mm-hmm. they may take care of in-person customers first, which I really don't blame them.
Yeah.
And the mobile orders and the online orders are kind of put on the back burner.
Okay.
And they build up. So I'd say maybe 75% of the time the food's ready, which is great. But there's also that 25% of the time where we're sitting around waiting.
Okay.
And that's possibly when cancellations happen.
Okay.
while we're waiting, I've drummed up conversation with other drivers, especially when I was new to it, just to pick their brain and understand what's going on. And I've had some of our drivers arrive, and they go, it's going to be another 15 minutes. They cancel the order on their end because they want something that's going to be ready right then and there, and they can go get it because the more deliveries you do, the more money you're going to make.
Okay.
You wait around for 15 minutes, you may not, you know, you're getting paid nothing extra for the wait.
So how does that work? So the driver has the option to cancel any order?
I believe so. I rarely do it.
Then what, another driver, the idea is another driver will come get it?
It will send the offer to another driver.
Okay.
Hopefully another driver will accept it.
Okay.
They'll go get it. Okay. When they arrive, if there's still a wait, it's up to them to wait or not.
Okay.
I usually, once I accept an offer, I try to fulfill it.
Right.
Because again, maybe I'm the minority, but I actually feel bad for the customer. Because I put myself in their shoes.
Yeah, they're waiting for it.
And we work for tips. That's another important tip, that we work for tips.
Nice.
But here's an example. Another pizza place.
Okay.
It was a Saturday night.
Okay.
It's crazy busy. I think I waited maybe a full hour for the order.
Oh, wow.
But
okay.
We have the ability to send messages to the customer. I kept giving them an update. Like, hey, I'm here. They say they're very busy. It's coming.
Okay.
I appreciate your patience.
Right.
And this doesn't always work, but sometimes the customer appreciates you reaching out to them, appreciates
the updates.
Your patience, your wait. So they gave me a really nice tip.
Oh.
So it turned out to my benefit.
Okay.
Most of the apps, I think when you order, you can enter a tip while you're ordering.
Right.
You can also change the tip after getting it.
Okay.
If you feel maybe they went above and beyond, you want to tip them more.
Add to
or if you feel like, well, he left it at the wrong house. He left it, you know, next door instead of at my place. I'm giving him no tip or less tip.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure you can adjust the tip.
Oh, that's interesting. I didn't realize that. Okay.
But with DoorDash, it will tell you the total expected for the delivery. It'll say like this one pays $9.
Okay. To how much you're going to make.
Right, how much we're going to make.
The driver, right.
Right.
Okay, gotcha.
But if you don't tip, that offer may only be $3.
Okay.
Or I've got them as low as like $2.25.
Wow.
So I always equate it to like, we're kind of like waiters, making like $2.25 an hour, $2.25 a delivery.
Okay. That's not much.
It's not much. And if it's nearby and I think it's going to be quick, I may go ahead and do it. But from talking to other drivers, a lot of them have told me, oh, if it's like $3 or less, I don't accept it.
Okay.
And I've gotten a handful of just $3 ones, and that's usually people who aren't tipping.
Right.
And I understand nowadays a lot of people are tightening their budget. I'm one of them, so I totally empathize.
Yeah.
But if you want to increase the chances of getting your food quicker, you should consider tipping.
Right.
Because if it's a $3 pay versus because we get all the tips. So if our base pay is $3 and you tip $4, our pay becomes $7.
Okay.
That's $3 versus $7. More likely a driver's going to go, oh yeah, I'll do that for $7.
Boop, okay.
Accept.
Okay.
And then we go do it. It's very rare that the tip's been changed. I don't think, maybe on a few occasions I've gotten it lowered, but not by much.
Okay.
I have gotten an increase, which is a nice surprise. It's like extra money.
That's good.
Now, how Uber works, Uber will tell you the estimated amount. Like, this one pays $10 with an estimated tip.
Okay.
After you complete it, it says, great, you finished that delivery. Your pay is $4.50.
Okay.
An hour or so later, the tip will be added.
Oh.
Because they give customer a grace period to adjust the tip.
Right. Okay, that's
so cool. It's kind of weird. Like, I was like, wait, I was going to pay $10. I got $4.50. Oh, I got to wait for the tip to post later on the night.
I see.
So it's kind of hard to keep track of how much I made for a day.
Okay.
Like sometimes I get home and for the next couple hours, like I'm getting notifications on my phone of tips coming in, which is kind of fun because it's like extra money coming in.
Okay.
But while doing the job, it's like, did I get a tip for that or not? I got to wait. DoorDash kind of tells you up front. And as soon as you're done with it, it says, great, you just got $7, including the tip.
Okay.
But I kind of got off sidetracked there. My point is, please tip.
Tip your drivers, always.
Right.
Now, because you're not making an hourly wage from
the
app.
No, it's per delivery.
This is straight I don't know if it's you want to consider it commission based or right. tip based.
The base 100%. They pay you a base pay.
Okay.
Which could be, and the reason why it varies is I think it's based on like you don't officially get paid mileage. Now Postmates does pay you mileage for each delivery. Okay. It's low, but they pay you something for mileage.
Okay.
My understanding is Uber Eats and DoorDash does not.
Okay.
But they pay you, like, if they know it's going to be a longer drive, therefore it's going to take longer, the base pay may be higher.
Okay.
Like, if it's something really short and local, it may only be $2 or $3. If it's further away, it might be $4, $5, or $6
okay.
before the tip.
Okay.
Like, I've been fooled a few times. I sent in a $6 one, assuming that included a tip. It was no tip. It was actually like a 30-minute drive. That's why they were paying me $6. I was glad that I got the $6, but right. I was thinking, oh, this is probably a $3 one with a $3 tip.
Right.
Because, you know, we're out driving while we're accepting these, so we can't really read all the breakdowns and all that, even if I don't even know if they tell you that. Usually it pops up, and they give you like 30 or 60 seconds to accept it.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And then if they don't, we'll get a notification. Because I've stopped to pump gas or, you know, something, and missed one.
Missed
like,
one.
You've missed an offer. I was like, oh, well. On to the next one.
Okay.
So you got to wait for your driver to get offered it.
Okay.
They have to accept it. After they accept it, they do have the option of declining it.
Okay.
And we're kind of at the mercy of the restaurants. Like I said, sometimes the food's not ready.
Okay.
So I've waited, like I said, that one place, I've waited an hour.
Wow.
I think the longest I waited was an hour and a half. It's rare, but it happens.
Wow.
I think we're creatures of habits, and it's become our habit now.
Mm-hmm.
Like Friday night, instead of going out, let's order some wings, fire up Uber Eats.
Right.
So that's great, because it's great for people like me who want to, on a Friday or Saturday night, make extra money.
Right.
But you also got to keep in a, remember, the more people using it, the longer things are going to take.
That's right, yeah.
So it's a perfect example, last May, Cinco de Mayo,
okay.
things were it's pretty much still shut down in May.
Yep.
But still, people still wanted Mexican.
Of course.
I went to a couple Mexican restaurants. They were so slammed. Holidays have become popular.
Right.
Like if it's Memorial Day weekend, you may still have a small to get together
mm-hmm.
or you have the day off regardless.
Mm-hmm.
People still cook out, but people also ordering in.
Right.
I've noticed like, and they'll tell me, I'll get a notification like, expecting high volumes this weekend, you know, because it's a holiday. For whatever reason, I think people just love the convenience.
So what other, I guess, tips or things that you want to share?
Well, yeah, another tip for customers is pay attention to where you're ordering from.
Oh, yes, we talked about this.
I have done some where, I can think of two, because there's a lot of locations of these.
Yes.
Recently, I had like a Taco Bell, and another day I had a Starbucks.
Okay.
And then it was like a 15 or 20 minute drive or something to the person's house, maybe even longer than that, maybe 30 minutes.
Yeah.
And along the way, I kept passing other Taco Bells or Starbucks. So I don't think people realize they're ordering from not the closest location.
Right.
And not only is that obviously going to take longer to get to you, they probably are going to charge you more.
Yep.
Because they pay, I think it was a further... longer delivery,
mm-hmm.
I assume they pay us a little bit more. So please pay attention to your location, because that seems to happen quite often. I don't think people are paying attention, or it may say Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Atlanta could be considered Dunwoody. Atlanta could be considered Buckhead, like Atlanta, Sandy Springs.
Right.
I think even like... part of East, not maybe East Cobb, but like where the Braves Stadium is in Smyrna, mm-hmm. some of that has an Atlanta address,
right.
even though it's Cobb County. So you may think you're ordering one someplace close, but you're not. Just because it baffles me, and I'm thinking like, do they really like that specific Starbucks over the one a mile from them?
That's exactly the same.
They ordered from one 10 miles away, and it's like then... if it's hot coffee, it may not be hot when I get it to you. Yeah, so that's a very good point. Thanks for reminding me about that one. Location, location, location. Pay attention to where you're ordering from. Just double check the address and think, wait, is this the one I'm thinking about?
Yeah, that's a really good tip, especially with the chains, right? Versus like you said, if it's a mom and pop and there's only one location, you're probably not going to screw that up. But if it's a Taco Bell or, you know, one of these chain restaurants where they're in every, you know, street corner, Dunkin' Donuts or something like that.
And another thing I thought of is
you got to look for where it is.
And one reason why I wanted to do this was kind of be an advocate for us delivery drivers is people always want to blame us because we're the last ones with your food. The restaurants can make a mistake. When I first started doing it, like Uber would ask you in DoorDash as well, you know, is the order complete?
Okay.
Are there like, you know, are there two sandwiches, not just one?
Okay.
So they wanted to actually like physically examine, not touch the food or anything, examine the order.
Right.
You know, I don't know if they want us to open the to-go box or peel them in the bag. They want us to, and it wants to make sure, because it happens, human error.
Right.
Something gets left out, a side gets left out, drinks often get separated. But ever since the pandemic, everyone has this new policy where they seal it.
That's right.
So we get these bags that are sealed.
Okay.
And they don't want us tearing the seal and looking at it.
That's right. They sure don't.
For example, I delivered something recently to a gentleman and I was handing him the sealed bag and he said, did they remember my drink? Because he even sent me a message, make sure they, and a lot of places, McDonald's, for example, they put the entire order in one big bag and then seal them.
Oh, wow.
Drinks, like they're in drink carriers. Okay. They put them in there carefully. I'm actually pretty impressed with that. But I can't look at the order.
Right, yeah.
Like, I don't know if there's only one fry versus two fries.
Or if you, I told them no ice in my drink.
And I think customers don't want us
nosing around. And
yeah, you know, poking at your food, breathing on it.
I wouldn't want you doing that.
It's more than likely the restaurant's mistake and not ours because we can't always verify the orders. Like, they'll hand me a bag and I say, this is it? This is everything? And they'll go, yep. I go, okay. And like, for McDonald's, people have weird requests like extra ketchup packets, you know.
Yeah.
They want sweet and sour sauce even though there's no chicken nuggets involved. Like, they want to dunk their fries in it or something. And I'll say, oh, the customer asked for sweet and sour. Is it in there? Yep, it's in there. And I just have to take their word for it because I'm not tearing open the sealed bag.
Right.
And a lot of places aren't leaving condiments and stuff out for us to grab.
Right.
So we have to like ask for it. And if they say it's in the bag and then hand it to me, I guess it's in the bag.
Gotta trust them.
But it's not always the driver's fault.
Good point. Yeah, there's a lot of variables and factors that could, you know.
Oh, another quick example popped in my head. And another thing you can do, I believe, on both apps is you can add instructions.
Okay.
I've had people say,
sure.
Gray house, red door.
Oh, that's good.
You know, in case, because sometimes like their mailbox on one side of the street, but their driveway's on the other, and that gets confusing.
Yeah.
Or they'll say, green Jeep parked in the driveway.
That's a good.
I go, oh, there's a green Jeep. I must be at the right place. Because another reason why, this is the point I was getting at, another reason why that is important, I was at night, I went to the house, it matched the number, you know, 3112 or whatever. I left it at the door, because a lot of people want a contactless delivery.
Right,
you just leave
that's
it.
That's where we're at.
And then I go to my door, and then they're talking to me. They go, we didn't order anything.
Oh, no.
And I said, are you not 3112? They go, we are. And I said, well, it's for you know, John A., because usually they don't give us the last name.
Right.
So they go, oh, John lives next door. So it could have been the customer did a typo. They 3111 and they hit 2 by mistake.
Okay.
And that happened twice.
Oh, man.
Where it was literally, one was a townhouse, so like.
It was the door.
Well, someone pulled in their driveway as I was dropping off their food. And again, he said, we didn't order anything. I go, well, this is the address they told me to go to. And he said, well, let me ask my kid. And he's like, did you order? Because a lot of times teenagers will order something and the parents don't even know.
Of course they will.
Right. Maybe with the parents' credit card, too.
Who absolutely, knows? With their parents' credit card.
It's like, no, we didn't order a thing. And then some lady from her window was like, are those smoothies? Like, yeah, those are for us. I go, oh, well, it's totally this address. So twice I was at the wrong house. It literally was next door. And again, it could have been a simple typo entering your address. I've also had people, please pay attention to your address. I've had people on like a Saturday doing Uber Eats or DoorDash or whatever. And they don't realize that whatever address they previously used is still in there. So I pick up the food. I've driven to their work.
Oh,
I've driven to like a doctor's office and it was closed because it was Saturday.
Yeah.
So I call and I was like, hi, this is your Uber Eats driver. I'm here at your food, but I don't think anyone's here. I give them the address.
Right.
They go, oh, that's my work. No, 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 I'm at home. And then they give me the correct one that you can't change on the apps. So I have to put it in my personal GPS and tell Uber it's been delivered, but I still have to deliver it to them. So pay attention to the location of the restaurant.
Okay.
Because you might be not ordering to the closest one.
Yep.
And your location. Because I've had 3 or 4 times where people have their work address, but they mean their home address, mm-hmm. or vice versa. They're mm-hmm. at work, and the night before they order it to their home.
Okay.
And I show up at their home, and no one's there. Or their mom's very confused. I mean, that happened once. They're very confused.
Yeah.
So those are a couple examples there.
And these are all very easy mistakes to make when you're starving to death and you are like hangry, I think is the word.
But if
you want food and you're trying to get that order in there real quick,
exactly.
Those are easy oversights to make.
But if you make those mistakes, it's going to take your delivery even longer and you're getting hangrier.
That's right.
So just take a moment, make sure you got your location right. Both locations, right? Yeah. The restaurant, your location, and consider a tip because that might increase the delivery time. Just saying.
It will help.
I think I've hit all the main points.
Yeah,
I'm sure once we start recording, I'll think of 12 more.
Yeah, but this has been extremely informative and helpful, I think, for anyone who is either already using these food delivery apps or considering using them, because like you said, they're becoming so much more mainstream because of the pandemic. I mean, we're at the, we've been in this for a year now, this pandemic. So a lot of people are using these apps more than ever before, and it's creating a lot of job opportunities, like for yourself, like to get, pick up some side gig money or whatever. So, this has been extremely educational for me just to listen to some of your tips, and hopefully for all the viewers out there as well. So any final thoughts or?
No, just kind of to kind of summarize, be patient.
Good.
Pay attention to the details. And my last tip is to remind you to tip.
Good tip. All right, well, there you have it, Mr. Duke Corey. Thank you so much for sharing your insights on the food delivery service apps that a lot of us are using now. And
just keep in mind, if you're watching this and you enjoyed this and you're in the North Metro Atlanta area, mm-hmm. I may be delivering your food.
You never know. So keep, pay attention to that face. So thank you so much for watching, and we will see you next time. I'm Jason Brown, Mr. Duke Corey. Thank you so much. See you down the road.